arm, or are you just being careful? Put a temperature gauge in mine this fall, because these 660s are notorious for running right on the edge of too hot, and real expensive to fix if you overheat them. The first time I noticed the two of you scrubbing the side, I looked down and said, oh, I'm up almost to 200. Scrubbed the bank a couple of times, got a little bit of fresh snow below 180. Been right around the 180 all weekend, or all day. All last weekend it was right around there. Yeah. That's all this has normally, box gauge over it at hardcore performance. I miss the old running board heat exchangers. Keep your feet warm, yeah. Keep the ice off the bottom of them. Ones have two dials, one for the thumb and one for the hand. And the Yamaha hand warmers on those things get just smoking hot. I buy another shellfish. And I knocked the left one off of it. When it showed that it had no left mirror, and I had it right here, and a spare right here. The second one, I don't even know where it went. It was moved down the trail like this, and the next thing I knew it was gone.
Never broke the
tree branch, but it snapped it.
So it cracked with little ashes?
Yeah. The first one, I was doing a turnaround on a real dinky road, and I had a brake on it for sideways. Did it for almost stop to get on the gas. Get a piece of it, run away, and keep the rest.
hit the brakes and then pinned it last second, trying to get it level, but it didn't work so well. Landed, didn't nosedive or anything, or buckle or anything, but landed hard enough for him to crash, like, his whole body onto the front of the sled, busted a bunch of plastic. The other part that's all fine, I struggled.
Punching and spinning it, and then you have the known will come up behind you. The cops are chasing and hit the lake. Take her down to ice. So, what time is it?
Is it noon?
One.
Really?
Well, should we have our barbecue?
Yeah, I know. Thank you.